Hello friends, welcome to Success Hub. Today we are going to discuss very important DI, because for the upcoming examination like IBPS clerk or the Canara bank, this type of DI that we are going to discuss, that is radar based DI, is very important, and we can expect this DI in the IBPS clerk also and Canara bank also. Why I am saying, because the recently one exams held, that is IBPS PO mains, this type of DI was came. So it's very important for the other exam which is going to come in the future, and we should be prepared, because when this DI came in the IBPS PO mains, means most of the students got stuck and surprised at how to solve this question, because they haven't seen in the life before this type of DI. But I am telling you guys that if in place of this chart, if it is a line DI or by DI, you can solve that DI or not. Yes, the representation is only different here, guys. The data which is represented in the line DI or the data which is represented in the bar DI, same data is represented here, guys. So only the diagram which you are looking like a spider web diagram, like a spider web, and you got stuck in the spider web, like any insect is going inside the spider web and got stuck. So like that, you got stuck in this spider web and you could not able to solve the DI because you are afraid of this figure or afraid of this chart. But I'm telling you guys that if in the near future, if you are going to any exam, going to give any exam, and any new type of questions is coming in the paper, I'm telling you with full guarantee that that question will be the easiest question of that paper. So if you are seeing any question, don't leave that question, attempt a question that one first. Okay, so we'll see how to approach this type of questions, and I will tell you how to solve the 5 questions in very speed and efficient way. Okay, so now we'll discuss the questions. Of the 5 questions we'll discuss, first questions in our, so this is our first question, that is total number of seats won by C is what percentage more or less than that by the D in all the states together. So before reading the question, our first job is to read the headlines. What is the heading? Number of seats won by various political parties in the legislative assembly of different states. So what is given, that there are 4 political parties there, that is A, B, C and D. These 4 political parties won different number of seats in the total 8 states. So total number of states is 8, and they won different number of seats. So what is the number, if I ask you what is the number of seats won by political party A in the Maharashtra, if I'll ask you what is the number of seats won by political party A in the Maharashtra, it is 30 or not, guys? See, 30. Yes, so this is represented. First line is 30, second one is 25, this one is 25, this one is 20, this one is 15, this one is 10, and this one is 5, and this one is what? 0. Yes, so everything means the line which is lying on this, or the line which is connecting this point and this point, is what? This one is again 30, this one is what? 25, this one is 20, this one is 15, this one is 10, and this one is 5. So all these things, now you have understood that how it is 30, how it is 25. So all the points, all the lines which are connected with this point, the lines which are connected with this point 30 will be the 30. Yes, if I'll ask you the Maharashtra, this point is what? 30 or not? Yes. Now understood how to, what this chart is representing. So now we'll move to the questions. So what is our first question there? The total number of seats won by C. So what is the total number? First of all, I have to find the total number of seats. What is the total number of seats won by C? Is what percentage more or less than that by the D in all the states? It is saying all the states together. So we have to find the total number of seats won by C. So what is the total number of seats won by C? Now C is represented with a green color, yes or no? So I have to find what is the, if I'll ask you what is the number of seats won by C in the Maharashtra, this one, yes or no? So this one is what, 5 or not? Yes. So total number of seats won by C in the Maharashtra is 5. If I ask you what is the total number of seats won by C in the Bihar, you will say directly here it is 10, because this one is 0, 5 and 10. Yes, so it will be the 10. Now if I'll ask you what is the total number of seats won by C in the MP, it is the highest, it is at the highest point. So highest point is what, 30 or not 30. Next one, what is the total number of seats won by UP, won by C in the UP? It is 30. This one point, this point is 30, this one is 25. So this one will be what? It will be, it will be 20 or not? Yes, it will be 20. Now next, Orissa. If I'll ask you what is the number of seats won by C in the Orissa, this is 0, then 5, this one is what, 5, and this one will be the 10. Yes guys, so total number of seats won by C in the Orissa will be the 10. If I'll ask you the next state, in the next state, Gujarat, that is what, it will be 20. And if I'll ask you in the Rajasthan, what is the number of seats won by C in the Rajasthan, it is a 5, and this one will be the 10. So number of seats won by C in the Rajasthan is 10. And what is the number of seats won by C in the Haryana? So this one is what, 15 or not? See, so this one will be the 15. So add it, what will be the sum? If we'll add it, 5 plus 10 15 15 plus 30 45 45 plus 20 65 plus 10 75 plus 20 95 plus 10 105 plus 15 120. Yes, so total number of seats won by C is what, 120. What is the number of seats won by D in all the states? Now you can calculate it. Okay, so now see, what is the number of seats won by C? So C is represented by the cross mark into or multiplication mark with purple color. Now what is the number of seats won by C, won by D in the Maharashtra? 15 or not? 15. Yes, then in the Bihar, 30, and in the MP, 25. So 15, so 15 plus 30 plus 25. Yes, next one, next state is what, UP. What is the number of seats won by D in the UP is 15 or not? Tell me. 5. Yes, then 10, then 15. Okay, now next one, in the Orissa it is a 20. Yes, so 15 plus 20. Next, find it in the Gujarat, it is 5 or not? It is at the least point, 5. In the Rajasthan it is 15. Okay, and again in the Haryana it is 5. So 5 plus 15 plus 5, add it. So 15 plus 30, 45 plus 25, 70, 70 plus 15, 85, 85 plus 20, 105, 105 plus 5, 110, 110 plus 20, 130. So this one becomes 130. And now the question is what? What percent more or less? It is asking what percent more or less, means I have to find a difference. So what is the difference? 10. So 10 is the difference. Yes or not? Yes. And I have to find with what respect, whom, with whom respect, I have to find the value of the percentage with respect to the D, means in the denominator it will be 130. So 100%. So this 0 and this 0 cancelled. So 100 by 13 is how much percent? If you know percentage to fraction conversion, you can easily answer that is 7.69% less. Yes, but if you don't know this one, 100 by 13 is how much percent, then divide it by 100, then 13, then you have to do like this and you will waste your time here. So better to remember this one, percentage to fraction. If you don't know, then I make one videos on the percentage to fraction conversions guys, and I will provide the link below, you can watch that one. Okay, now we'll move to the next question, question number 2, and see what it is. What is the question number 2? What is the ratio of the total number of seats won by A to the total number of seats won by B in all the states together? So it is asking the ratio of the seats won by A and B. So I have to find the ratio of A by B. Yes or not? What is the ratio of A by B? So first of all, this I have to find it, what is the number of seats won by A in all the states, and A is represented by a blue color. Yes or no? Now see, in the Maharashtra A is winning 30 seats. Yes, in the Bihar 5 seats, in the MP 15 seats. So 30 plus 5 plus 15, 30 plus 5 plus 15. Now in the UP, tell me, in the UP how many seats are winning? In the UP it is 10, in the Orissa it is 25, again in the Gujarat 25. So 15 plus 25 plus 25, yes or not? So, and up to Gujarat we are done. Now tell me, in the Rajasthan, what is the number of seats won by A? That is 30 or not? And in the Haryana it is 20, yes. So plus 30 plus 20, so what is the total number of seats? 30 plus this one is what? 20. 30 plus 20, 50. 50 plus 10, 60. 60 plus 50, 110. 110 plus 50, 160. So this one will be 160, yes. Now what is the total number of seats won by B in all the states? Now B is represented by a red color square, yes. So what is the number of seats won by B in the state Maharashtra? That is 20, this one. In the Bihar, again 15. In the MP, that is the least number of seats won by B in the MP, that is 5. So it will be what? 20 plus 15 plus 5. Now after that UP, what is the number of seats won by B in the UP? That is, this is 25, this is 30, yes or no? And this one is what? 10. So it will be 25 plus 30 plus 10, yes or guys? Now next one, in the Rajasthan, what is the number of seats? This one is 25 and this one is what? 10. So plus 25 plus 10. Hope you are understanding it very well, guys. If not, you can comment in the comment box and I will reply you as soon as possible. Okay. Now add it. 20 plus 20, 40. 40 plus 25, how much, guys? 40 plus 25 will be 65, and 65 plus 40, 105. 105 plus 25, how much? 105 plus 5, 110 plus 20, 130 plus 10, 140. Or you can add it like this. 20 plus 20, 20 plus 20, 40. Okay, leave this 25. 40 plus 30, 70 plus 10, 80. 80 plus 10, 90. And this 25, and this 25 will be 50. And 90 plus 50, 140. So what will be the ratio of A and B? So ratio will be 160 divided by 140. This 0 and this 0 cancelled, so it will be 28 by 7, yes or no? So divide 2 times, 28 to 7. So answer will be what? E. Now we will see to the next question. What is our next question? Now next question is, if 30% seats of Maharashtra legislature, it is talking about the Maharashtra, okay, legislative assembly, are won the females, okay, means third of the total seats in the Maharashtra, 30% of the seats are won by the females, okay, 40% seats of the Gujarat, so it is talking about the Gujarat, are won by the females, okay. So out of 100%, 40% seats are won by the females. So it is asking the male members, so be careful here, it is male members. Till now it was female members. So then the male members of Maharashtra assembly are what percent more or less than the male members of the Gujarat assembly? So before that, I have to find what is the number of seats in the Maharashtra, yes or no? So number of seats in the Maharashtra is what? 30 plus 20, 50. 50 plus 15, how much? 65 plus 5, 70. So in the Maharashtra, total number of seats is 70. Now tell me, in the Gujarat, what is the total number of seats in the Gujarat? So total number of seats in the Gujarat is, this one is how much? 25 plus 20, 45. 45 plus 10, 55 plus 5, 60. So in the Gujarat, total number of seats is 60. Now out of this 70 seats, 30% of the seats, out of this, listen me carefully guys, out of 70 seats, 30% of the seats are won by the females, yes or no? 30% seats are won by the females, then what percent of the seats won by the males? Means if 30% is won by the females, yes or no? If 30% are won by the females, so what percent of won by the seats won by the males? Tell me. it will be 70% or not. 100 minus 30, that is 70%. Means I have to find a 70% of 70. Yes guys, so it will be what, 49 or not. Okay, big understood. Now in the Gujarat, 40% of the seats are won by the females. So what percent of the seats won by the males? 40% is female, so 60% will be the male or not. Okay, so 60% of 60 will be how much? 36. Now tell me, in the Maharashtra is more or less in the number of seats won by the male in Maharashtra is more or less? It is more. Yes, and how much more? How much more here? It is 13 more or not? So 13 more. I have to find a percentage. Why I am telling you, we have to find a difference because it is asking the what percent more or less. So we have to find a difference. So 13, so it will be the 13 divided by, and I have to find a percentage with respect to what? I have to find a percentage with respect to the Gujarat Legislative Assembly, and in the Gujarat Legislative Assembly it is 36 into 100%. So this one, if you will find it, it will come how much? How to find it? There is a two way of finding this one. 1300 divided by 36%, divide it and then find it, or else you can find it like this also. 36 is how much percent? 100%. Yes, then 3.6 will be how much percent? 10%. Okay, 0.36 will be how much? 1%. Okay, so we'll use this three things to find the answer. Okay, now see, 3.6 is how much percent? 10%. Okay, so if I multiply 3, then it will be 10.8 will be the 30% or not? Tell me yes. You can ask me why I'm multiplying 3, why not 4? If I multiply by 4 guys into 4, if I multiply with 4 into 3.6, 10% into 4, if I multiply by 4, 4 into 3.6, it will be 14.4 or not guys? Tell me. So it will be 40%. Yes, and tell me here it is 13%. So my, you can analyze it, 13% of 36. 13% of 36. Yeah. Listen carefully, 13 is what percent of 36? So 13 will be what, more than 30% and less than 40%? Yes or no? Because 40% of 36 is how much? 14.4, and I have only 13. So 10.8 is how much? 30%. Okay, so you got it, my answer will be more than 30% but less than 40%. Yes. Now come to the option. See the option 60.28, and I told you my option should be less than 40% and more than 30%. I'm again telling you, more than 30% and less than 40%, option number D will be eliminated or not? Option number C will be eliminated or not? Yes. So I have remaining two options, A and B, and I told you it is 13 more, means what, my answer should be in the more. So option number A will be the correct answer. Yes. So I don't have to find the exact percentage, just check the options, you can easily find it. So this is method of solving the objective questions. Okay, now we'll move to the next question and we'll find the answer. Now see, 40% of the Haryana Legislative Assembly, 40% of the Haryana, so it is talking about the Haryana states Legislative Assembly, and 50% members of the UP, it is talking about a two state, that is Haryana and the UP, are charge sheeted for involvement in crimes. Among these, 50% and 20% are females. In the Haryana and the UP Legislative Assembly respectively, then the number of males, see here it is talking about the females, percentage is given of the females, and here it is talking about the number of males in the Haryana Legislative Assembly who are charge sheeted is what percentage more or less? Again, more or less means I have to find a difference. Yes, then the now here it is females members of the UP, so male member of the Haryana and the female member of the UP Legislative Assembly. So before that, what we need to find? We need to find a number of seats in the Haryana and number of seats in the UP. So first of all, find this one. What is the number of seats in the Haryana? So it is what? This one is what? 20. Yes or no? This one is 20. Here it is 15. So 20 plus 15, 35. 35 plus 10, how much? 45. 45 plus 5, 60. 45 plus 5 will be 50. Yes. Now come to the UP. What is the number of seats in the UP? This one is how much? 25. This one is how much? 20. This one 15. This one 10. And okay. 25 plus 20, how much? 45. 45 plus 15, 60. Plus 10, 70. So the number of seats is how much? 70 in the UP. Now out of this 50 number of seats, 40% are charge seated, means they are involved in the crimes. 40% are involved in, I am writing in the only one step here, 40% are involved in the crime. Yes, no need to calculate right now what is the number of, no need to calculate the number here, number of males, number of members, okay, no need to calculate here, okay. Now out of this number of member are involved in the crimes or not? Yes guys, this number of male members are involved in the crimes. Now out of this, 50% are the females. Yes, so what will be the percentage of males? It will be 50% only. Yes or no? So 50% are means if I'll take this one, 50% of males of total number of seats are involved in the crime. Yes, so this one will be how much? 100. This zero cancelled. Yes, 50 two times. Yes, two times. So total number of males involved in the crime is 10. Got it? Now in the UP, 70 seats are there. 70 seats are won. Okay, out of the 70 seats, 50% are involved in the crimes. Yes, so means this is the total number of members involved in the crimes. Total means male plus female. And out of this, so this is what, male plus female. Out of this, 20% are involved in the females. 20%. And if I'll take 20%, so this is what, only the female member which is involved in the crimes. Yes guys, so what will be the value here? If I'll calculate this zero cancelled, 20, 5 times 5 cancelled, so 7. So the number of female members who are involved in the crime in from the UP state is how much? 7. Now it is asking what percentage more or less. So what is the difference here? 3. So 3 by 7 into 100 by percent. If you know percentage to fraction conversion, 100 by 7 is how much guys? 100 by 7 is 14.14%. Yes, and I have to find 3 times. 3 times means multiplied by 3. So it will be how much? 42.42% more or less? More. Yes, 42.42% more. Okay, now we'll see the last questions. Very easy questions it is. Let's see the easiest question of it, the 5 question. Which political party won the highest number of seats? It is saying that which political party won the highest number of seats in the given 8 states. There is a 2 way of solving, by finding number of seats won by A, number of seats won by B, number of seats won by C, number of seats won by D. By this 2 way we can solve it, or we can go with the options also. See, first I will check the A. What is the number of seats won by A? If I will take in the Maharashtra, in the Haryana, in the Rajasthan, in the Gujarat, A is winning the highest number of seats. Yes or no? And if I will take the C is winning the least number of seats in the Maharashtra, then second in the Haryana, then here again least number of seats in the Rajasthan, again second in the second number of seats, again least number of seats in the Odisha. So we can say that A will be greater than C or not. Yes, so option number A is eliminated. Likewise, if you see, option number D will be also eliminated, and option number B, C will also be eliminated. You can see here B, you can see that A is winning the highest number of seats in the 4 states. So A is greater than B, A is greater than B, A is greater than B, A is greater than B here. And so in these 4 states, A is winning the highest number of seats and more number of seats from the A, B, C and D. Yes, so like this, If we'll compare it, A will be the highest number of seats winner. A will be our answer. So answer option number D will be the answer. Okay, hope you understood and enjoy the videos. Okay, if you have any doubt guys, please comment on the box in the comment box, and you can ask me anytime and I will reply you as soon as possible, and in the best way I will reply you. If you like my videos guys, please subscribe and like it and share with your friends, so that this will videos will help you and your friends also guys. Okay, bye bye guys, have a nice day.